Arc Zero versus SSG. If you are just joining us, and it's our very final map on Cafe.
Very fun map indeed, but it requires a lot of work on the offensive side to make it happen. Team has to be firing in all cylinders, those comms have to be clean, and you gotta make sure that you put that defense in its place. Otherwise, one misstep could lead to the ultimate demise, as this map is definitely not fun to handle man down. As we jump into the offensive bans, though, we're gonna have the last one roll in here, so we'll see how hindered the offense is. Double hard destruction ban, Dark Zero doubling down.
It's going to make trying to access certain areas of the map relatively difficult. This will be limited to basically just Maverick getting it done. Just as a note, folks, if you're watching comp for the first time or it's been a while, Ace is not in play right now and will be restricted for at least a few more weeks. Mira is going to be the first of our defender bans coming out, so following a much more usual trend there. And I think I would expect the same of our final defender ban to come out here as well. Let's see and just make sure. Ah, it's actually going to be a clash ban as the final one. So that'll be an interesting turn of events. But again, makes sense for the playstyles that we often see here on Cafe.
Completely agree, especially with Mint in the lineup on Dark Zero. Obviously, one of our resident shield mains inside of North America. Already playing a shield earlier today on Consulate with that Blitz pick. So going to try and limit his operator pool as much as possible, but obviously Mint can be effective with other operators as well. Dark Zero going to be in the offense, SSG starting on defense here on Cafe. A little different from the prior two maps that we've seen, and we are going to be headed towards Fireplace Mining first.
So an interesting start. We've been seeing more and more teams do this where they oftentimes will go to their secondary or tertiary site choice to start off with instead of going directly to the primary one in hopes of sneaking off a quick round win at the beginning before reverting back to it. Another Blitz pick as well on the sixth pick there, just locked in at the last second for DZ. That's the second time now we've seen a Blitz pick come in for them so far in this series, counting the one back from the first map as well.
It could help them out quite a bit when it comes to trying to move people off of certain positions on Cafe, mainly because Blitz can basically just walk at them, and unless somebody has an explosive, it's pretty difficult to deal with him. Obviously, with no smoke in play either, he is actually going to be quite potent, but that can always fall to the wayside if Mint ends up getting taken out early on. This is an operator that's hitbox actually extends past his shield, so you're actually able to shoot him in the shoulders and such, especially when he's leaning. But when it comes to Mint's play with this operator, he's quite the veteran of it, so I don't expect anything to go sideways.
Other than the obvious reinforcements downstairs, we are going to see the extended hold setup upstairs as well, as you might expect, including reinforcements on hatches and a few other walls, just to make sure that SSG can try to play an extended roam here for as long as possible. And hey, you guys might be seeing it on your screen right now. We've got some new Pro League sets in game. Make sure to hop in and check those out. They're on sale right now, and more importantly, for a limited time, the Pro League teams will be receiving, or the Pro teams will be receiving, a share of the proceeds. So make sure you guys are hopping on that opportunity to support your favorite teams while the offer's live.
Yeah, very cool of them to put Zoronic in the game with that bandit skin as well. You know, I think that's a beautiful, you know, little Easter egg there.
What, full beard on that
and
one,
the mohawk,
right?
He's got it all. He's got the full thing. Yeah, like I actually think we would have to have a competition between those two.
It's a great cosplay setup for him at a future event, right?
Absolutely, we have to see it happen. Maybe SI next year, who knows.
Yeah, we already got one for Milosh. Now we gotta expand the roster of it. Fluke as well has done some cosplay, I believe.
Yeah, dude, Fluke goes all out. I love that guy. He's such an amazing commentator, great human being overall. So anyways, jumping into the round now, though, as we're about halfway through, some soft destruction done from Dark Zero from below to set up some nitro cells in case anyone wants to swing into stage upstairs inside of Christmas. Dark Zero doing a bang-up job of droning through. No damage dealt to either side, but there's going to have to be some contact at some point, and it seems that Mint is going to be the linchpin needed for that.
Continuing to tick down here, but for Dark Zero, already with some good control upstairs to work with and start to leverage down into mining. Whether they'll be able to successfully do that or not, of course, it's still a matter of the next minute and 15 seconds. Although they're moving very, very quickly, following off from the end of the previous map, going right into the site, still with over a minute on the clock. Bosco denies the extra push going deep into the site, and Canadian will also trade out a few other players in the midst of the site. The plan is down, yes, but are they holding? That's the big issue that they're now going to have to deal with. Sky's also on the outside. He's going to have no choice but to swing in and take control of Fireplace. Start wrapping back around, seeing if he can deny Bosco's counter defuse. Already presses against him. He'll be taken out by Canadian. It's a different playstyle from Dark Zero. We always love to see that, but this time around, unfortunately, it is not going to pan out, and SSG quickly get the retake and counter defuse to take the opening round.
Looks like cafe, smells like cafe. It's probably cafe. That's just how it plays. That right there, hard execute, try to get that diffuser down. Works out for them, but the trades are so quick. Nice adjustments from SSG, specifically inside of the pillars area to shut down that very aggressive front. They were able to take out the blitz, and that's the biggest thing there. If Mint was allowed to stay alive, that post plant is going to be damn near impossible unless you're able to overwhelm him. But with those post plant positions that Dark Zero had, that probably would have been all she wrote. But instead, SSG able to win it out. We are going to have the six pick yet again. Dark Zero trusting their gut here with these shields.
Yeah, once again, committing very heavily to the blitz, which for those of you who may not watch Siege so often, is an operator we rarely see get picked. I think just from this game alone, his pick rate has probably skyrocketed a few positions just from the three times he's been picked so far
in
this series.
Let's see here. I'll be able to get you the pick percentage here momentarily, my friend. It seems as that
he's got to be like 2 or 3% somewhere on there.
Fun fact, I don't even see him on the operator list on offense. Yeah. So it's that low.
They didn't even consider him.
He doesn't even exist.
He's not even worth considering.
Exactly. He's fallen into the Matrix.
Well, he's certainly being considered for Dark Zero at a minimum so far in this matchup, and he's been having some mixed results, that's for certain. But like you said, Dark Zero seemed convinced of his usefulness here, so he's going to be picked up for a third time going into the second round now, as SSG is going to look to defend the kitchen sites that have an extended hold from them, specifically on the first floor, as Rampy's going to be holding the inside of the Christmas first floor room. Canadian also still opening up some rotates for himself and the rest of his teammates to play off of, as well as that extra barricade to support their Jaeger in the inside of Christmas tree.
Well, doing a little bit of extra digging here as we are in the early stages of round two. Blitz has only been brought one time prior to this from Dark Zero in a sanctioned matchup, at least within the last 6 months, as I believe that's how far back these stats go comparative to the other ones. So that's quite a long time there for the Shieldman.
Quite a long time indeed. King Nate here looking to deny some drone presence coming in from the main cafe doorway. Also chucking out another disc real quick here. Staggering those as best he can to eat up the impending flashbang dump that's going to come out from Dark Zero at any moment. Unfortunately, it looks like he eats one right there at the last second. That'll also lead to the elimination of his shield. He'll still be swung out from Prep Kitchen, taking an incredibly aggressive angle. Whether he'll stay there or not, that was yet to be seen. And it does look like he did eventually retreat to the depths of Prep Kitchen, where he's now going to wait for the push. But it's not just him here. Fultz is also playing from behind the bar. And we are going to see him pick up one before going down. One-for-one exchange brings us into a 4v4. They still have to play against the Womai and Prep Kitchen, so it's not such an easy breach, but Thinking Nade falters quickly when pushed. Hyper takes him out, and that's going to be Dark Zero taking not only control of Cafe, but the man advantage in the round as well.
Thinking Nade just not ready for that swing from Hyper, and what a time to make it happen. Still have the shield up for Dark Zero and Mint, and he's been so successful so far. He only has one kill, but that's not really the bulk of the work for the Blitz. He's able to get so much intel off of just his presence being there. Granted, Monty is available, but we haven't seen him used yet. I think the Blitz is a lot better for Mint simply because he's able to sprint out of some bad situations because of who he's playing. We do have some interesting positions here from SSG, specifically Bosco with a shield on top of Sink. It's a very nice position, but this is a very long distance gunfight with this SMG 11, so if there's anyone that's going to do it, it's definitely going to be Bosco himself.
Canadian also trying to take some angles against players downstairs. Had a slight glimmer of one, I believe, for a moment, but not really anything that he would be able to react to, unless we're assuming he's a god of reaction time or something of that nature. You can never expect that from players at all times. Another fight going to be taken here by Rampy. He gets a bit of damage off, I believe, onto Eclipse over there. Not going to be able to take him out just yet, though. More attempts to push in are being made. Diffuse are going to go down onto the ground. Bosco with a nice angle to hold against Mitt. Hotton is also going to get taken out. Everything falls to Eclipse now. Finishes off the fight from earlier by taking out Rampy. And now leaves just Canadian and Bosco in the exchange here, both of which are going to be in position to try and pinch out Eclipse, though. But the player on his flank's already revealed. Oh, so unfortunate timing, but Eclipse gets away from it anyway. He's now going to try to force the issue against the smoke, but it won't work out. Bosco is going to be able to win out that fight. and we'll have plenty of time for the counter defuse. A 2-0 lead is now established for SSG.
That one's gonna hurt for Dark Zero. That's two plants in a row that they were not able to secure. SSG continually win these post plants. Some great play there from Bosco to keep himself alive. Great peaks and amazing utility usage there, especially with that Toxic Babe clipping through the wall into Flower. Some very nice showing there. Might have a 6-pick off of the Blitz, though, as Mint's going to be showing it straight up this time. That's usually a telltale sign that something's going to be adjusted, but obviously we'll have to see exactly what their idea is of it. We're just making some predictions here. We are going to see that Maverick brought, as we're more than likely going to be seeing him this whole time, as previously discussed, Habana and Thermite off of the board.
Getting into the midst of the round here, we'll see if there's going to be any more 6-picks, but a common usage actually in this series, and it's had quite a bit of usefulness to the 6-picks compared to what we normally see from them, which is either just like, you know, 6-picks that don't actually matter in the grand scheme of things, or that where they're like very predictable for their opponents. But we've actually had quite a bit of variety on them so far in this game, and they've been quite useful as far as I can tell to bring the Legion in this round with it.
Well, we're headed upstairs for SSG. Bar defense, the most known site on this entire map, is not too much has changed with it since the map update. There has obviously been a few things added with some balconies and such, but it's still relatively the same positioning-wise. We see a lot of pixel play. We see a lot of shields played up here from the defensive side. We'll see how SSG utilizes that, especially with the Goyo in play here. They're going to actually be setting up bathroom is what seems to be a standoff area. They're going to soft destruct one of the panels towards Christmas and put a shield inside of it. Not a Goyo, though. They're actually going to put that... Oh, no, they are. They're going to switch it out here and play one of the explosive shields instead. And that's actually a very big deal. They are only bringing the Jaeger as they 6-picked off of the Womai, more than likely because there was no Capitao in the lineup for Dark Zero. Didn't really need it, as well as Womai has some trouble here playing certain positions. So, for SSG now, see if they can continue this reign of terror that they've had on the defense of locking out these post plants.
Things are continuing to look good at the moment here for SSG, and just now only having to retreat to the upstairs site as well. So this is normally the site we'll see teams go to right off the bat, but because of how much has been played out, that oftentimes means the attackers are very well prepared well for an attack on this site too. Blitz once again, as I'm sure you guys have noticed, still in the picture here for Dark Zero. It seems to be a very hefty part of today's cafe strategy, definitely not in trend with any sort of meta that we would expect, but like I said, I appreciate the innovation, especially at a major level.
I appreciate it as well, and that also means that we're going to be seeing a lot more Legion, as that's exactly why that ob was designed in the first place. Shields and rushing operators in general are very, very annoying. He's supposed to be that thorn in their side, not making it to where they cannot sprint, taking away that ability. But oh my god, what a shot there from Skies. Reads Canadian perfectly as he's trying to get rid of a drone, but instead all of his life is pulled from his body. Halfway through this round now, though, is Mint's halfway up white stairs. They do have the diffuser still on this mid-level, as that's where most of the Dark Zero bodies are for the time being.
Piper backing out after the initial success being found against Canadian. Don't necessarily feel like it's the best route to push, and they're probably correct about that. They don't really have a lot of skylight pressure, and even if they did, it's not in the correct angle right now to pressure Rampy out of position, so he's still going to be free to swing around this U-shaped balcony and try to punish Hyper or anyone else from DZ that may try to push in from the library door.
Beautiful setup here from SSG that is delaying so much time, but now Hyper on the Eastern Rappel here trying to play the cocktail windows. Does have to worry about one inside of C2. That's going to be Foltz with the Evil Eye Man himself, Maestro. Ping gets sent out now, though. They need to be able to deal with it. That's going to be Rampy now gone. Fiber's just three, but low on time. They need to find their way through this neck of the woods as they try to force their way up white. Smoke grenades out as Toxic Babes continue to pour down, stunting the growth of this offensive push here. Bosco now out completely, though, of the Toxic Babe. Shotgun in hand, gets fully blinded as he tried to chase him down. Oh no, Mint's actually gonna end up downing one of his teammates and also gets a Goomine stuck in his leg. He's not gonna be able to sprint. Checks close, not able to melee either. It's back and forth. This is a war of melees, but Mint finally gets it. Oh my, I thought Bosco was actually gonna be able to stick it out, but he was fully blinded. As you can see, Mint used his utility at the last second.
Bosco just panic spamming V, unfortunately, as he can't see a darn thing and still nearly ends up running it to timer there, but doesn't end up being a success. Finally, the play there on the blitz, the consecutive play on the blitz for three rounds straight, works out into their favor on the white stairs push, and they are able to take full control on top of other successful executes in order to get control of a round for themselves. 2-1 is going to be the scoreline. The first failing, of course, from SSG, but they will begin to unlock the sites that they have already won just after that loss. That's going to take them right back to Fireplace Mining.
Quite an interesting one there from Dark Zero. Did not even touch Christmas, which is usually the standard that we see for that site, but instead clearing out the mid floor and then attacking via the windows for Cocktail as well as White Stairs. Utilizing that shield so dang well, the only way that they could possibly slow them down was those Toxic Babes, but once the Toxic Babes were expended, it was all up to the heads-up gunfight. And as you guys know, that's not the most fun, especially when you're going up against someone that can blind you with the shield.
Let's see if there's going to be anything different. This time, we've obviously noted the fact that the Blitz has finally been six-picked away from as they went for the direct pick this time. I mean, now retreating over towards a Thatcher instead. We should expect much more traditional play on the attack for this site here. SSG pretty much bringing the same flare as before. They've even picked away from that Legion, so they might even have started to expect that, all right, maybe the Blitz is not going to come into the picture here for this defense, as it didn't work out too well for them on the first time they tried it.
Well, the good news is that they've won a round now with Blitz, so that's good. That's a good thing.
that was the whole goal. They just wanted that one victory.
They just wanted to prove that it works at a competitive level.
Yeah. Just carry the Blitz through one round and get the win, and then that's enough to prove it.
Oh, man. I really wish that we would get another clip of like what he did on Clubhouse a while back, where he just ran into sight and cleared the entire area all by his lonesome. It's very, very impressive, but probably not going to see that, especially on Cafe, with how this plays out in the space in between teammates and that such. But I'm going to have SSG back on this mid-level hold playing mining right now. Nice setup upstairs, castle barricades and such to make sure that they can keep Cocktail windows locked down a little bit longer than previously. Gonna need some soft destruction over there to be able to get rid of those, or at least some frag grenades, and that seems to be the expense of that right now. But Foltz capitalizes on that, takes down Skies, and that's an early pick that was much needed. That's quite a bit of soft destruction off the floor.
Some potential unfortunate timing here. Foltz is gonna commit to the top out. I'm not sure if he heard the rappel from Hotten or not. I would assume yes. But here we go. There's the leap. Yeah, and Hotten reads it like a book. Quickly takes out Foltz and eliminates him for attempting to make that play.
Very unfortunate for him.
Yeah, nice little attempt to change it up at least with a separate window, but just not going to pan out that well, unfortunately. So that evens things out. Puts us back down into a 4v4 now. Big risk being taken, and unfortunately, to not much success. Puts SSG back into an even position for the rest of this round here. You can see Canadian, of course, roaming around. Has a good idea about those two players pushing from top red, but needs to figure out where the other two are as well. At the moment, there might be a lapse of intel on SSG, which could cost them over the next 30, 40 seconds as we'll begin to see Dark Zero move into positions to execute.
Well, that's a troublesome thing for Dark Zero as well, is that drone utility could be sparse right now, but checking in on that, it doesn't seem like the economy is too hindered. So we have quite a few drones still active and some still inside of pockets. And with no mute on the board, those are more than likely set up in positions to watch for rotates and those crossfires. 50 seconds remain for Dark Zero to get a plant here. Last time they were here, it was that quick rush plant into mining, but this time it's a lot slower on the windup. Reaching charge is still going down to create some vertical angles as they're trying to get this SSG member out of train.
Bosco still hoping for someone else to swing into that window position where he would be able to punish it. He makes it a little bit cleaner there so we can toss the gas grenade through it. He's got pressure coming up from top as well. You'll see a nitro thrown below. Is it going to be on position? Yes, it will. Sends Eclipse flying and it was death this time around. Two more players also getting dropped back to back. That's Mint and Hotten going down just within about a half second of each other. And now everything once again falls to a single member of DZ. It's Hyper versus the world here with less than 10 seconds to start the defusal process. And unfortunately, he doesn't even have possession of the device needed to do that. So SSG will shut it down. They'll take quick control of round number four. And after a bit of a bump in the road upstairs, things go very much back into their court here at a 3-1 scoreline.
That shows you exactly why Cafe is so dang difficult. Yes, they were able to trade out equally and make it 4-4. But when you're on the offense, there's just so many rotations to worry about, so many crossfires as well, and a lot of utility to burn through. And there's quite a few positions where the defenders are quite safe, just like Bosco playing inside of Train. He was there for the most part of the round, and they were not able to get him out of there, even with the vertical play being utilized. So for Dark Zero, it really is just trying to get these early picks and not get traded, but that's the difficult thing here.
All right, guys, let's see if we're going to end up with any more. Hey, and the Blitz is back.
Hey-o.
I was about to say, big surprise on that one. That'll bring DZ back into their usual fold for this. And once again, this is a site where I think we saw, if I remember correctly, we saw the Blitz get knocked out pretty quickly against this defense, so we didn't really get to fully see how it would be utilized here. So get a better picture of that. I would imagine it's going to be a pretty big piece of the execute working its way in through prep once again, but also SSG had a pretty good setup to try and stop that type of a push as well. There was some great angular play that they can work off of, both from the inside of the A site along with by playing into the inside of Prep Kitchen. It was just that Thinking Nade in that last round kind of got wrapped on pretty quickly at Prep Kitchen and like was not ready for it, so he got eliminated. If he was able to keep himself in position to play against the actual push from DZ there, either him or his teammate playing on the other side would have been able to shut that down, especially the case if they're going to continue to leave this wall soft. They've already got the rotate through it, so I don't believe they would be reinforcing it.
I really want to see Fultz have more of an impact inside of Bakery here. Yes, SSG was able to win the round last time, but obviously it was off the back of some very good play there down to the last second between the last two remaining SSG members. Hopefully this time their Bakery hold goes off without a hitch. Obviously last time reinstating Thinking Nade, not having the best time inside of prep. Assuming that he thought Mint was more than likely going to be the front man for that, but he definitely was not. It was Hyper swinging that door, and with Fultz picked off early on as he swung very aggressively towards the kitchen, the Bakery double, did not work out for him. But he does still have two ADSs as Dark Zero is setting up outside of Small Bake.
And I like the change up to the overall opener here from Dark Zero. If they can pinch from both the primary door along with the side hole and the small by the window there, then that is going to make it a lot easier to deal with this setup they have both behind the main Bakery desk and behind this reinforcement that Thinking Nade's playing right now. Dark Zero thinking quick on their feet, quick to adjust, just to follow through, where sometimes things go poor for them. Elsewhere on the map, away from all the action that's happening by Bakery, Skies is going to get eliminated, trying to get, I believe, control upstairs. Actually, no, shot out through an upstairs window. Thank you very much, Sino, for observing that for me. Going to be caught by Rampy, who was holding upstairs and had an opportunity to peek out through a window for free.
Hey, he got his frags, and that's all he needs to do. You saw him scampering up upstairs, and Canadian's going to make it even more difficult for Dark Zero now, as Mint and the shield have been deleted. No longer can you just walk in there and allow bullets to hit the front of your body, not take any damage. Hyper now trying to help Eclipse as they're dealing with the man inside of restaurant. Eclipse swings wide, takes down Rampy. Still a minute and 20 seconds left on the board, so this is definitely still doable. But as we continue to try and push this envelope home for you guys, remember how difficult this can be for the offensive unit here on Cafe, especially with how much time they're wasting. Canadian dipping and dashing inside of White, but finally able to get cleaned up by Hot and Cold. He was down by Eclipse, but now we're on equal man count. They need to find their way into sight, though.
Even man count, as you said, but Dark Zero have lost a lot of health on Hyper and Eclipse. That's going to limit their capability to try and take some of these fights. Might need Hotten to get lead the charge here in some of these, or at minimum be ready to trade to keep his HP at max here to have a better chance of closing down this round. 40 seconds left here, so actually plenty of time for Dark Zero to try and formulate how exactly they want to push for this. Oh, near disaster for Dark Zero, but Hyper saves it with the great hold, keeping his teammate alive and preventing disaster as Thinking Nade tried to creep out and killed the Maverick. Tried to kill the Maverick, I should say.
Well, this is where things can get very desperate, especially with a Maestro still alive, but he's quickly dealt with. It's all down to Bosco now, and Boss Goat does not appear. The shotgun's removed from the map, and Dark Zero with three man up when their offense finally getting a little bit closer here. We're more than likely going to see this 2-4 split, but that depends on where we're going. SSG has been so good on this defensive side so far. That really, truly was the only misstep they've had.
Excellent turnaround there from DZ, and as you mentioned, the first big mistake that we see from SSG in the midst of that round. Costing them heavily, though, is it's going to bring the scoreline incredibly close, 3-2, potentially a 3-3 if we see more success picked up by DZ against this attack. It is going to be a rerun of the same site. SSG lost their only other reasonable site choice, which is back up on the third floor, and it seems they do not fancy going for the fireplace and library site, which is the alternate option for the second floor.
Okay, well, we are going to six pick off of the buck, which isn't the best thing in the world, really, mainly because of the site that we're going to. We're headed towards Kitchen, and without Buck being there, they're going to be leaning on breaching charges to do a lot of the heavy lifting inside of that vertical play. Granted, they are going to have quite a bit of that with the Ash and Hyperplane, that Zofia. Obviously, two impacts on her and two breaching rounds on Skies with that Ash. Means they can get quite a few angles opened up, but still begs the question, how are they going to deal with Bunker, as Buck is usually a little bit better at handling that angle. Obviously, you have to worry about your utility getting eaten up from those Wumai discs and ADSs when it comes to breaking things inside of sight.
No, folks, Dark Zero are going to be let out once again. You can expect the similar approach to come in their overall strategy, with a lot of the emphasis being on getting control of Bakery and Small and moving their way into prep, eventually taking site control from there. This is due to the fact that SSG are leaving that wall soft, trying to actively play against it. And for the most part, Dark Zero has been handling playing against this aggressive hold fairly well, either by forcing the SSG members back into site or by outright eliminating them, as we've already seen from the previous two attempts. So SSG have brought the castle into the pick for this time here. Almost forgot castle's name for some reason. And are going to be able to reinforce some extra utility here to hopefully prevent the crossfire that Dark Zero was able to get against the Bakery Hold last time.
I mean, you can always just lean on, you know, wave check castle skin. You know, that's how you remember. That's how I remember it.
I don't know why. Like, it's like I'm trying to remember.
Veli wave check skin win. That's all I want to know.
I was like really scared for a second. I was like gaffing on his name for like 5 seconds. I was like, oh my god.
Very unfortunate there. But Dark Zero now picking up Thatcher as well, as we didn't see the six pick over to the Blitz, which could definitely assist them in that department that we were discussing earlier on, dealing with those of my discs and ADSs. This is something that Thatcher specializes in, getting rid of these electronic pieces of utility. And when it comes to those, he doesn't disable them. Oh no, no, no. He destroys them, so that's going to be quite a bit of utility burnt there, and he can also assist inside of those evil eyes as well. There's so many applications for the EMPs, I could go on and on, but obviously there's a game to be played here. Soft destruction now for the Dark Zero side. Got quite a bit broken up here on the mid level, and good drone work here. Don't face check that hole, must rather use that drone to check it for you, using that as an extended life, at least for a vision. Don't need to capitalize on it just yet. But for the most part, SSG playing on this bottom floor and trying to lock down any of the entry points that DC could possibly use.
Grampy holding on the inside of Kochek as well, waiting to see if Dark Zero are going to try and swing his angle here. SSG very much trying to prevent access for DZ at this point, since they're not necessarily able to use the usual angles that they've been using in previous rounds. Still success from Dark Zero, though, because the SSG members are so out and about. Dark Zero are able to isolate one of them and lock them down. It's going to be Canadian getting knocked out there just by the main bar.
That's the terrible thing about that is, you know, once the pinch has happened, you seldom get out. There's way too many angles to worry about, and trying to move around usually ends up getting you killed. A swing here from Rampy, but he misfires, and Eclipse ends up winning it instead. That's a double for him on the round, as they're finally getting down onto site. But they do have to still worry about some Roam presence that we see here, as actually, no, that's a member of DZ working his way down the staircase. Apologies for that, but Plant could possibly be going off now, though. Five man up is DZ as we go into the last 15 seconds. Hot and cold locking into that diffuser. He's halfway through. Waiting now as the evil eyes have been picked up. Oh, it's actually going to be confirmed as well, as there's still members of SSG on the field inside of sight. Has been planted at the back of Bunker, as Bosco is the last remaining member.
There's nothing connecting here, unfortunately, in this round for SSG. The aggressive attempts getting locked down by Dark Zero and eventually killed off, and the players in sight just not able to defend much here. Bosco with a great shot on Hotton to take him out, but it's only the beginning of a very long road to recovery. He's already used most of the defusal time, and he's barely gotten started with this clutch. He's locked in a corner, as you can very much see from the bullets that spray out the second he tries to move from said corner. Even with that, tries to get a second kill, but is not going to be able to accomplish that. Skies takes him out, and Dark Zero do indeed round the comeback, make it 3-3 at halftime.
Well, it seems as though the kitchen has a rat infestation, as it's all of the Dark Zero members are literally everywhere, not a single safe area for Bosco to rotate. And that's actually going to be their only successful post plant and their entire offense. But they still tie it up 3-3. I'm really starting to feel as though Veli's prediction was right. It really does feel like overtime.
Could be the case. Hopefully get a better picture and once we get past this first round or two on defense for Dark Zero, we get to see what exactly both of these teams are going to be bringing to the table for their second half as well. could still end up with a very dominating one-sided nature to this if one team gets off to a good start. But at the same time, we've also seen teams get off to that hot start with a consecutive three rounds going in their favor. And then the second go-around is pretty much the exact opposite. So that leads us into the current situation we have before us now. Time to see if it's going to remain just as competitive now that the teams have switched.
Well, we're going to be headed downstairs for the very first round here for Dark Zero. Similar operator lineup, but we'll see if they have the same idea while setting things up. For Skies, he is going to be on that smoke, and this has been something that's been notable for Skies throughout his career now, is that he's transitioned away from these more aggressive type operators, playing a more passive front for his operator lineup, and it's actually been working out quite well for him. He's found quite a bit of success with Dark Zero in this position. We'll have to see if he's able to lock things down here on Cafe. Currently 4-1-4, but as you guys can see, looking over to the other side of the fence, Bosco playing the same position, currently 8-1-3, so that smoke can definitely make the difference.
All right, guys, so let's see how Dark SSG's attack, is going to fare for them here. On the very first round of the second half, you can immediately see off spawn, you've got a couple players potentially working their way over to the inside of Bakery. Bit of drone work to be done on the inside there first, of course, before they commit themselves to it. That's not going to be the only area where we'll see some attacking presence established. Fultz is also messing around with the front door, leading over by coat check into the main bar too. It seems that DZ might be aware of this, just not necessarily aware of where exactly it's going to come from. But all that will be revealed over the next few seconds here as SSG is starting to open up the windows and again, that little bit of aggression here. They'll see that the setup is very similar to that they used just the two rounds ago.
Well, Dark Zero, quite an aggressive showing here off rep, especially from Skies on this smoke. This is something that we definitely don't see every single day, as usually the smoke's utility is sacred to the defense to be able to slow things down when the offense is getting down and dirty, trying to force their way into the defensive site. But for now, he's playing actually out inside of the coat check hallway, but he does have some assistance here. Specifically, Mint playing in Whiskey with the shield setup. Almost halfway through the round now, though, but you can definitely bet your bottom dollar that SSG has gotten quite a bit of intel. As you can see, their drones are a little worse for wear than usual. Already four down, well, actually five down, as Rampy is also missing a drone, but there is no utility on the defensive side that can obviously shut them down. They're all going to get destroyed, whether it be from an evil eye or a bullet.
Trying to set up a pinpoint ping here for his teammates to use to be able to isolate out some of this utility. And in the meantime, Skies considering a run up to the second floor to try to punish some of that positioning, but it's not going to be able to get it hot. In the meantime, confirms Fultz with the evil eye. Not something you see popping up on the kill feed too often. A bit of extra damage going on to Canadian from that as well, it looks like, before it's finally ending up being dealt with there. SSG still on the outside, still, unfortunately, with not a lot of sightbound control, and they're under a minute remaining here on the clock. Now, Dark Zero has so far has been doing a fantastic job of delaying, if not outright denying, the SSG pushes here at the beginning.
And here comes the hard part. Not very many drones left, as it seems that there's only two active drones, and those are more than likely for flank watch for the offense. Nice use of a Maverick torch hole here from Eclipse, bags him Canadian and makes the offensive situation even more difficult than it was already. Trying to work their way into Whiskey, but they have to worry about the castle. The ump doesn't work out for Mint, and it's not in Canadian's hands, so doesn't exactly shoot straight apparently. Still have Skies here on Red Stairs, and he could definitely have a good showing. Has one to worry about inside of Whiskey, but he's got one even closer. If he followed the bullet trails, oh no, doesn't even have to worry about it. Hyper there to assist, and it's going to be DZ all over the board here on their first defensive round.
Solid team play coming out from DZ, constantly in sync and communicating once again with the current positions of the SSG players to lock them down, as you saw at the end of the round, save teammates in more than one situation, preventing them from having to take fights that potentially could have led to their deaths. Great hold, and it's going to net them not only the first round of the second half, but since they're coming off of a 3-3 half, it's going to get them the lead too. 4-3 has now been established. We are three rounds away from DZ taking control of this series in a pretty upsetting fashion, given what everybody expected coming into today.
Yeah, I think that the biggest shocker so far, without obviously knowing the outcome of the series, was Clubhouse, a 7-4 finish in favor of Dark Zero. I didn't expect that one to happen. Truly, I thought Consulate Dark Zero was going to battle for it a little bit harder, maybe push it to OT and win it 8-7, then SSG would win Clubhouse, but things have kind of been flipped on its head today, at least from my perspective.
Definitely the case. And Dark Zero again, massive props to them for putting up this fight and bringing the overall improvements from the previous weeks. Definitely bringing it here where it matters the most at the Major. It potentially could set SSG up for bad times if this continues to go into DZ's favor and potentially ends up with a win for them. SSG, as we already saw though at the end of Clubhouse, are not one to take the loss in a map without at least giving a good fight for it. So we should expect some more plans for them to try and counteract what DZ has been bringing to the table. Put SSG back in a better position where they can hopefully take the lead back too.
Well, here's the very difficult thing for SSG right now. They're used to Rampy, Bolts, and Bosco all having very good games, but we're missing two key aspects of that sentence that I just said, John. Rampy and Fultz are completely dormant right now.
Unfortunately, just have not been there when it comes to the fragging departments, as they have often been met with quite a bit with regards to the early round fights that they've tried to take, and more often than not, it seems like they've bitten off more than they can chew, or it's just been pushed so far, you know, later into the round that they don't really even have to act as entry anymore. They just end up being part of the main pushing force, and even there, it seems like success has been limited for them within this match. It's a good point, Stokes, and we'll now move on into the round itself to see any improvement in that regard. You can see Skies, of course, looking for things with the heartbeat sensor, trying to scout out if there's going to be any downstairs pressure to start off with from SSG, and will then swing up to the second floor, but not looking like it. For the most part, SSG are going to send their entire team in through the roof to do a top-down clear.
We'll see how well it fares this time as Dark Zero's poised for some gunfights, pre-firing quite often and early on here to see if they can slow down SSG, if at all. Skies on the pulse here, using that cardiac sensor to good use, finding quite a bit of information early on. This is good. As long as they're able to recognize where this push is coming from, this means that they're going to have educated gunfights, meaning that they know when someone's going to be peeking them, or at least their positioning, so they're prepared for it. That's what we see happen, you know, quite often where somebody gets caught off guard by that, and Pulse can definitely help you out with that, especially with his sight play.
Well, we can see here, Thinking Nade still looking for options in order to get better control here before he moves any closer to the site. He knows he's in a very dangerous area. These guys as well will be able to confirm the positions of a few other members of SSG still hunting out upstairs here. There was a Nitro Cell pre-placed somewhere that I heard out of the corner of my ear just a moment ago, but I'm not sure if it's lining up with any of that right now. And yes, it seems like it was. There we go, building right into that perfectly. Hotten with the perfect timing on the detonation, gets a double from it. Goodbye to most of SSG's pushing force, and goodbye to the round as well. It's a flawless hold from DZ as they are starting to dominate here on Cafe, inching themselves that much closer to a victory in the series versus SSG.
Oh, that's going to be a rough pill to swallow there, as practically a tactical nuke goes off inside a freezer and kills two inside a bathroom. That is the exact opposite end of the spectrum from what we saw in Consulate with that C4. So this one going off without a hitch and ends up claiming two lives. 5-3 now into the favor of the defense. Very slow moving there for SSG, and amazing intel gathering there from the defense that led to that very successful round for Dark Zero.
Just expect to be utilized here to bring Capitao in instead of the IQ. Should play out pretty well, but the problem is SSG needs to get to that point in the round where they're ready to execute for that Capitao to have any use. And as far as the first two rounds are concerned, they haven't even been able to get it to that point. So this may be some hollow utility if they run into those same issues. The good news is they're now attacking the third floor, so getting to that execution point is nowhere near of a massive task as it is on the other two sites. And more importantly, Bosco can still utilize this utility regardless from the skylight just above the B-bomb chassis.
Well, it seems, friends, as for this round, we're going to have a shield fiesta going on. We have Mint playing the Goyo. He provides two of those, as well as two in the secondary utility department for the remaining Dark Zero members. Skies and Eclipse picking those up for the team, and only one roll of barbed wire to worry about for the offense, but quite a bit of utility to burn through otherwise. When it comes down to it, the offense is, as of late with this utility burn meta that's been going on for quite a while now, usually leads to a very front and forward attack, trying to work their way through all of that defensive utility. They have quite a bit of it as well, though, and if they're able to capitalize early on, we could see Bosco having quite the effect with those Capitao bolts.
Let's see specifically how they're going to be utilized here. As SSG is getting into position after the drone phase has ended, we're already going to see the large majority of their players head right up to the roof, as you would generally expect. Wouldn't be too surprised to see if we have one or two of them on rappel or just kind of standing by on lower floors here, too. That's pretty much exactly what we're going to get. Still, as usual, a bit of drone work to be done, though, so they're not going to commit themselves to anything just yet. Bosco opening quite a few of the windows here for some play potential. A drone will get spotted out of the corner of Hot and Cold's eye, but he as well is going to get spotted as a result of said drone, so he needs to reposition himself into a different spot of the map, and it looks like he's going to fall back behind the defender-sided bar over here just by the B chassis.
Very nice setup here from Dark Zero, going to make SSG fight for every single inch. Definitely like the shield inside of the white hallway as well to prevent anyone from rappelling to the white stairs window and killing Womai inside of Pixel. Almost halfway through the round now, though, as SSG is beginning the burning process on these ADSs, but they've dedicated all three of them here. The other one is actually sitting in the corner next to the stage stairs up towards the piano. And obviously, since Womai gets his discs over time, this is going to continue to be an area where he can stand upon this hill until he dies.
See Hotten with a good start here. Only taking out Canadian, but Piper's going to be able to follow that through to eliminate Fultz. Other three players now being restricted a little bit, including Bosco being way on the outside here on rappel, still trying to play from my piano. It does throw in one of the firebolts, it looks like here, try and flush out a member of Dark Zero's defense, whether it worked or not. I didn't get to catch that too much. We're going to see the second one utilized now to flush back the player holding the white door. There's another player, though, on the breach in the bathroom, so I don't think he can safely swing in. He's going to have to take a risk if he wants to go for it, or he'll have to spend time repositioning, which is not necessarily something that SSG have a whole lot of right now. Only 40 seconds left, and they're working from a 3v5.
One of the SSG members currently prone inside of Christmas with a buck shotgun, but he's got a shield. He rotates around. Do they know he's here? He's switching back and forth. Peekaboo, my friend. Stun grenade out. Forces himself inside. What a play from Rampy. Oh, my. Whips out the skeleton key. Able to take down one. Switches back to the primary weapon, but now Bosco's locked inside of a plant. Still four members up, but do they know Thinking Nade's here? Oh, my God. It's Dark Zero all over the board. What a messy round there near the end, but all of the bloodshed falls on a Dark Zero side.
So unfortunate for Rampy there, as we saw him trying to make a gorilla play with the buck, just crouching up to the soft wall, hoping he could find an easy skeleton key kill on the other side. Instead, he's met with two reinforced deployable shields there, which he just can't get anything past. Tries to wide swing into the white hall and is quickly taken out. And as you saw at that point, it was already a 5v2, so it's not too much additional trouble for DZ to shut the rest of that push down. They're on map point now, and match point as well, to potentially pull off the reverse sweep here after going down 0-1 in the first map. They're about to bring it back with two consecutive maps in a row, including the win on Clubhouse, which up until the start of the NAL was a very rare thing against SSG.
We'll make you guys aware just one more time. If you are a member of the SSG family, if that's your team that you root for every single time that you watch Rainbow Six Siege, do not fret if they end up losing this. They do have another life. They're not out of the tournament just yet, but obviously you don't want to see them lose. You'd much rather see them keep that life and continue on throughout this tournament. But for now, though, Dark Zero on map and match point, as John just said, and they're headed downstairs to see if they can lock it out. This is the time where we need to see those entry frags step up. Rampy, Fultz, you guys are shells of yourself right now. Find that ghost inside, bring him to the forefront, and make him battle. You're desperately, desperately needed.
The good news, and somewhat for SSG, is that this is the similar scoreline where we really started to see SSG begin to bounce back on the previous map once Dark Zero had pushed it all the way up to six rounds for themselves. SSG is now facing similar pressure and even greater pressure, seeing as it's the end of the series itself. A potential lower bracket run is in the future for SSG if they do not bring this back. So if there's ever going to be a rebound, now is the time. But Dark Zero are looking incredibly strong on this defense after their turnaround and back in map number two. It's not really looking like they can be stopped right now. The play from them is far too potent to work against SSG.
Last little touch-ups on site for Dark Zero, and they're good to go. Drones out for the SSG squad, as their main focus is going to be Bakery once again, and they're going to be handling it through the small Bakery window as well. Sky's no longer in the smoke as he's shifted gears over to the Legion. Probably a better pick for this position just because of the distance of those gunfights. Granted, again, these are professional players. We've seen a million shots with the SMG 11 at range, but oh no, it's deja vu. We saw Rampy get a pick earlier on Disguise from this exact same window, but instead it now happens to SSG, and that's a huge one as well. Thinking Nade off the board, no more air jabs. This is going to be a jungle gem for Dark Zero.
Revenge is indeed sweet as SSG tries to pursue the sweets on the inside of Bakery up until this point, really unsuccessfully. Dark Zero looks like they're potentially going to throw a lot more aggression out at it. You can see Eclipse assisting here as they've also got Hotten on the corner hold. Hotten just spamming out with the remainder of the Alda magazine there. If you're not necessarily a Rainbow Six player, that is easily the most ammo-heavy gun that you're probably going to end up with access to on your normal setups for defenders anyway. So he's got quite a bit of ammo to utilize there, as you can see. Still isn't reloaded, by the way, and is going to pick up the kill onto Fultz to push the advantage for DZ even further into this round, now at a 5v3.
Point to realize that he pre-fired as well as killed someone, and now he just got the same amount of bullets as Habana has in her primary AR. That's how the Alda works. Stun grenades now over as Hot and Cold continues his reign of terror, but finally taken down. It's only left up to Bosco in this one versus four. He's going to have to find the clutch. He has plenty of time, but no flame utility left with his arrows. He's trying to crouch walk his way in here, but the bad news is he's got to face check literally everything. No drones, but it seems that his presence is known. He downs one, now down to the one versus three. Peeks out through the prep double. Not able to find too much just right now, as it seems the rotation's going around for Dark Zero. Down to the one versus two now. They need to stop giving him these solo push kills. Otherwise, Bosco could definitely clutch up. Yeah, I know he's on low HP, but we are talking about the boss goat here. This is the most clutch player in all of the NAL. With 30 seconds remaining now, he needs this diffuser as he continues to fight through. Has to worry about Skies inside a coat check, but Skies is going to scamper off towards Whiskey, where his other remaining teammate is. It's going to be Mint. Now with only 15 seconds remaining, Bosco is more than likely going to have to stick the plant, and that seems what the plans are for Dark Zero. He wants to try and break line of sight and plant in a very unknown area, but the Wamai disc catches it, starts to plant directly on 7 as they have to move in. Do they know exactly where he is? They do. Skies checks it from the red hallway, and Dark Zero with the upset against SSG here in our first match of the day.
Beautifully played by Dark Zero. A lot of creative things being brought to the table by them as well. Obviously with some mixed results back in the first map, but things started to come in and work a lot better as we got into maps number two, and especially here in the third and final map. Beautiful work indeed by D.